Hello and welcome to ABR Facts 2012, and ABR Facts continues to educate you about sitting. Well, by now you have understood that paradoxical reactions and absence of well-developed sitting platform make sitting incredibly difficult for a quadriplegic spastic child. But the next question is, what causes those troubles? And more importantly, what to do. So this is what we are going to discuss in the next video. Spastic quadriplegic child, the big secret of sitting. And the logical question that we are going to answer here is also, is it possible to do something about it? And what actually has to be done? So our next step is going to go into the details. What are the reasons why there was such trouble and what actually has happened? What did we do? What have we done? So, in order to make this remarkable transformation possible. And that is going to require a closer zoom. Well, let's do this zoom, right? So, what we're seeing here, this is that sliding that we experienced. And now, let's zoom in and what we are going to see. We are going to see this remarkable trouble. This is the ribcage which is completely folded. It's folded onto itself, where you can see that this depth is completely lost and the ribs just sink in, right? So just a minor insertion, right? Just a minor insertion here, you can see complete flatness. So he just sinks in altogether. And at the same time, there is another remarkable thing. Well, what is it? This is a direct conflict. Rib cage and the pelvis graze and come in conflict with each other. So, no wonder that this boy cannot move. It's impossible to bend him. Imagine your ribs getting stuck over your pelvis. Well, it wouldn't be a surprise that you wouldn't be able to move. Right, so you see, and here I'm trying to bring my finger in, and well, it's really, really difficult. So to squeeze it inside, and at the same time, once I manage to do this, you can observe how collapsed is the abdomen and how collapsed are the ribs posteriorly. So this is a depletion, and this is a central message that I want you to take from this particular part. Yes, what we've seen externally is incredible stiffness, is difficulties of the spastic kind, but what we can see behind them, extreme weakness. But on the other side, on the right side, we actually see the next extent, a more pronounced conflict. Because over here, if you look closer, you're going to see that here it's a direct conflict. The ribs are pretty much always locked onto the pelvis. So no wonder that he doesn't like sitting position, no wonder that this is really troublesome to bring him into any sort of controllable placement, because, well, this is just this direct conflict. There is simply no room. And now let me ask you a simple question. In this particular situation, do you think that any attempts to deal with the legs or any stretching or any Botox injections, not to mention even the things like hip interventions with surgery, would they ever help this child? Well, I hope that you're starting to get the understanding that if there any kind of therapist or treatment, no matter what kind of like rank and file he has, if he misses these fundamentals in quadriplegic children, namely their depletion of the trunk, and if he doesn't have any tools to work with it, well, you have to realize that their opportunities to help your child are extremely limited. And this unfortunate example of this 16-year-old, really, really nice boy, you know, like with quite a charming personality, well, you know, he's a living proof of this thing. 16 years of trouble, 16 years of effort, and nothing to show for it. And what we're seeing now? Well, actually, we can see the remarkable transformation. Well, this is the base. Now, if you compare the two, First thing that you're going to observe is the remarkable improvement of the depth. So the depth of the thorax has really improved. There is really the space there. So the lower ribs, the posterior components, they are far from being as collapsible, but the key thing is there is now space. So if now there is space in between, this is the reason why he can actually be moved, right? And that's why the sitting position has become so much more comfortable. And we can see this not only on the right, but we'll see this, we can see this not only on the left, right, the side's confusion, but on the right side as well. So before we've seen dramatic conflicts, remarkable challenges, the ribs just being physically stuck against the pelvis. No wonder that was the source of troubles. And now we're seeing this excellent room, and this excellent room allows for movement. So that's the big secret. That's the big secret behind the achievements of this boy. And again, this has been earned. This has been earned by several hundred of hours that his mother put into his body via the ABR work, bringing what we call a transfascial strengthening, the strengthening of the deep fascial core, the connective tissue core that he has. So this is really essential. This is really important for you to understand. And I hope that you are actually taking a good, insight from it and making the link and connection for your own child that, well, if you until now have been too busy with the legs or too busy with the arms or too busy with trying to teach your child to do something and never actually looked at the fundamentals, well, this is a significant mistake. And I would invite you to start thinking differently and actually start seeing differently, because you're looking at your child every day, but you are not looking at the right things, you're not looking at the core things, you're actually chasing their effects instead of looking at the causes. So that's the first big part of this. Now let's get even further, and then we're going to see other ways of seeing the transformations and other way of understanding the room for improvement and the difficulties experienced.